Dear students, good morning, good evening, good afternoon. How are you? I hope best for you. I, Mukesh Kumar, welcomes you to online, Mukesh Online Academy. आपका Mukesh Online Academy में स्वागत है. And we are doing the maths of class 8. ICSE board and the reference book that we have taken is the M.L. Agarwal. And we are doing the chapter 2, that is the exponents and powers we are doing. We have already covered this chapter into various videos in which we had covered the laws of exponents. We did the examples. We did few questions of the exercise. And now in this video, we will be completing the exercise number 2. Okay. That means we will be doing from the question number 8 till 13. That has been left. Okay. Now one usual tip. I hope you must have taken out your notebook and pens. Start practicing meaning. Okay? If you see, you know, to become best into the maths, practice 3 to 4 times. Then you will become best into the maths. Each and every question. Okay? So there is only one secret in the maths to become best into the maths. That is the practice. Practice, 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 more practice. And high hope, you must be doing that. Okay? So, if you have any query, if you have any doubt, then you can write to me on the WhatsApp or email. And if you want to get the live online classes, then also you can write to me on the WhatsApp or email. We do the classes on the Zoom app, interactive classes. Okay? So, we can clear the doubts also. Okay? And I hope you must be getting knowledge from these videos. Kindly share it with your friends. Ask your friends to subscribe. Okay? And you also subscribe to it. Share it. And now, in this video, what we are going to do is the remaining question of the exercise 2. So, now let's do. So, dear students, so today we will do about the remaining questions of the exponents and powers. You are doing the exercise 2. So, we have done already in the previous videos up to the question number 7. So, today we will do from the question number 8. Okay, so let's do the question number 8. Now, the question number 8 has got the 4 parts. So, first we will do the first part. Okay, so the question number 8 part is 49 into z is to power minus 3 upon 7 is to power minus 3 into 10 into z is to power minus 5. Okay, so we will use the laws of exponents here. Okay, so the question is 49 into z is to power minus 3 upon 7 is to power minus 3 into 10 into z is to power minus 5. Okay, so first what will we do? We will just write 49. Okay, the 49 can be written as 7 into 7, that means 7 is to power 2 it can be written. So we will write 7 is to power 2 into z is to power minus 3 upon 7 is to power minus 3 into 10 into z is to power minus 5. Okay. So now this 7 is to power minus 3, it will go up. As I told you, when it goes up, see, or we can do 7 is to power 2. We can use the law that a is to power m upon a is to power minus n equal to a is to power m plus n, that we have learned previously also. So same thing we will apply 7 with 7 also, and same thing we will apply with z also. Okay, so we will write 7 is to power 2 plus 3 into z is to power minus 3, this 5 will go up, so it will become positive, plus 5 upon 10, because 10 we have not converted. 7 2 plus 3 is 7 is to power 5 into z is to power 3 minus 5 is 2 upon 10. Okay, so we have got the answer 7 is to power 5 into 10 is, z is to power 2 upon 10. This is the final answer that we have. Okay. So again, repeat. So what we have done, we have just converted 49 into 7 is to power 2. And then we have just used the law h to power m upon h to power minus n equal to h to power m plus n. And then we have arrived at the okay. Now the second part. Okay. See, in this question, we have 9 is to power 3 into 27 into 2 is to power 4 upon 3 is to power 2 into 3 is to power 4 into 3 is 5. very simple question. Okay, so 9 can be written as 3 to power 2. So we will write 3 to power 2 and outside the power 3. And 27 can be written as 3 into 3 into 3. That means 3 to power 3 it can be written as. So 27 can be written as 3 to power 3 into 3 to the power 4 upon 3 to power 2 into 3 to power 4. That means we can use the law h to power n into h to power n equal to h to power m plus n. So it will become 3 to power 2 plus 4 into 3 to power 2. Okay. Now here in the first one, 2 into 3. That means we can use the law here that h to power m h to power n equals to h to power m into n. So that means 3 to power 2 into 3, and 2 into 3 will become 6. So 3 to power 6 we will write. See, this we have written here. Into 3 to power 3 into 3 to power 4 upon 2 plus 4. 2 plus 4 is 3 to power 6 into 3 to power. Okay. So now we can take 3 to power 6 just like the thing that we have done, h to power m divided by h to power n, or we can write h to power m upon h to power n equals to h to power m minus n. So we can write 3 to power 6 minus 6, and then into 3 to power 3 into 3 to power 4. 3 to power 2 can go up, will become minus, but 3 to power minus 2. The same law that we have applied in the whole question. So this became 3 to power 0 into 3 to power 3, and 4 minus 2 is the 3 to power 2. 3 to power 0 is 1. So we can write the answer 3 to power 3 into 3 to power 2. And 3 to power 3 means 3 3 is 9 3 is 27. So we got the answer 27. 3 square is the answer that we have. So this is the final answer that we have got. 27 t square is the final answer. Okay. So now do the third part. In the third part, we have 3 to power minus 2 to power 2, then 5 to power 2 to power minus 3 into 2 to power minus 3 to power 2. And then again 3 to power minus 2 to power 5, then 5 to power 3 to power minus 2 into 2 to power minus 4 to power 3. See, in everyone we have the exponent outside the bracket also. So we can use the same law h to power m equal to h to power m into n. We have used the law that h to power m h to power n will be equal to h to power m into n. So all three here. Everywhere we are using this law. So this will become 3 to power 2 minus 2. This 2 and 2 will be multiplied, so it will become 2 to power minus 4. This 2 and 3 will be multiplied, so it will become 5 to power minus 6. This 3 and 2 will be multiplied, so it will become 3 to power minus 6. Now here 2 and 5 will be multiplied, this and this. So this will be 2 into 5 is 10. So minus 2 into 5 is -10. Into here 3 and minus 2 will be multiplied, it will be minus 6. So 5 to power minus 6, and here 4 and 3 will be multiplied, so it will become 3 to power minus 12, because 4 into 3 is 12, we have minus 4, so we will write the minus 12. Again we will use the law that h to power m divided by h to power n equal to h to power m minus n. Now since we have the negative powers on both the sides, so we will write h to power minus m h to power minus n will be equals to h to power minus m plus n. Okay, so it will become 3 to power minus 4, and when 3 to power minus 10 go up, so it will become positive. So we will write plus 10 here, same the law that we have used, into 5 to power minus 6, and then we will write plus 6 into 3 to power minus 6 and plus 10. Okay. So, minus 4 plus 10 means 10 minus 4, which is the 6. So, we will write 3 to power 6. 6 minus 6 is 0, we will write 5 to power 0. And 12 minus 6 is 6, so we will write 3 to power 6. As we have already learned that if the any base has the power 0, its value is 1. So, we will write 3 to power 6 into 3 to power 6. And 3 to power 6 means 3 into 3 into 3. Into 3 into 3 into 3. So 3 3 is 9, 3 3 9 3 3 9, so 9 9 81 into 9 became 729. So we will write 729 raised to the power 6 is the answer. So that we have got here by using the applying the laws of exponents. Okay, or we can leave the answer as 3 to power 6 with 3 to power 6 also. So both way we can write. So now let's do the 8th, 4th part. So now in the 8th, 4th part we have 2 to power minus 5 into 15 to power minus 5 into 500 upon 5 to power minus 6 into 6 to power minus 5. Okay, so same we are going to use the laws of exponents here. So we will write 2 to power minus 5 into 15 can be written as 3 into 5. And then outside we will write the power minus 5, 500. See, 500, we have to take the prime factorization of the 500. Okay, so 5, 100, 5, 20, 5, 4, 2 and 2. So that means we are getting 2 times. So that means 500 became equal to 2 to power 2 and 5 3 times into 5 to power 3. So we will write 2 to power 2 into 5 to power 3. Divided by, we have the 5 to power minus 6 into 6, we can write 2 into 3, and outside we can write the power minus. Okay. Now, we will write 2 to power minus 5. See, we will use the law here that we have discussed that a into b is to the power m. So this m will come to a also, m will come to b also, it will become a to the power m into b to the power m. Okay, so this 3 into 5 will become 3 to the power minus 5 into 5 to the power minus 5. Okay, then we have 2 to the power 2 into 5 to the power 3. Divided by, we have 5 to the power minus 6 into, again same law we will use here also, that we have used the upper one. So it will become 2 to the power minus 5 into 3 to the power minus 5. This minus 5 will come with the 2 also, minus 5 exponent will come with the 3 also. Okay. So here, first let us do, take this 2 to the power minus 5 and 2 to the power 2. So we will use the law here, a to the power minus m into a to the power n equal to a to the power minus m plus n. Means 2 to the power minus 5 plus 2. So this 2 and 2 we have done. Now 3. We don't have anything for 3. So we will just like 3 to the power minus 5. And then we will take 5 and 5. Means 5 to the power minus 5 into 5 to the power 3. With the same law we will apply here. That we have done earlier. Okay. So it will become 5 to the power minus 5 plus 3. Then we will write. We can write 2 first, 2 to the power minus 5, then we can write 3 to the power minus 5, then we can write 5 to the power minus 6. Minus 5 plus 2 is 3, minus 3, okay? So 2 to the power minus 3 into 3 to the power minus 5, minus 5 plus 3 is minus 2, so 5 to the power minus 2, upon we have 2 to the power minus 5 into 3 to the power minus 5 into 5 to the power minus 6. So now, we will use the law same that we have used earlier also, like a to the power m minus m divided by a to the power minus n will become a to the power minus m plus n. Okay, so this will become 2 to the power minus 3, minus 5 will go up, will become plus 5 into 3 to the power minus 5 plus 5 into 5 to the power minus 2 plus 6. This will become minus 3 plus 5 is 2, so 2 to the power 2, this 3 to the power 0 into 6 minus 2 is 4, so 5 to the power 3 to the power 4 is 1, as we have discussed earlier also, so 2 to the power 2 means 4 into 1, 5 to the power 4 means 5 into 5 into 5 into 5, 5 into 5 is 25, 5 to 5 is 25, and 25 into 25 is 625, we can multiply that. So 625. So now we can multiply 625 and 4. So 4, 5 is 20, 4, 2 is 8, or 2, 10, 4, 6 are 24, 25. Okay, so we got the answer 2500 is the answer that we have got. Either we can write this 2 into 5 to power 4, or we can write 2500 is the answer. Okay, I hope you would have understood all the parts of the 8th question. If you have any problem, then you can write. So now let's do the 9th question. We have the 9th question. By what number should 3 upon minus 2 to power minus 3 be divided to get 2 upon 3 to power 2? Okay. I hope the same question we have done in the examples also, you would have seen that. So first, what will be right? Let number should be x. Okay. So we have just assumed the number to be x. By what number this should be divided? That means 3 upon minus 2 is 2 power minus 3 should be divided by x. What is the result that we get? Is 2 upon 3 is 2 power 2, that we should get the. So this is how we can make, we have made the equation. Now we will solve it. Okay. So we will write 3 upon minus 2 is 2 power minus 3. Okay. As I told you in the rational number also, when we divide the number, okay, we just put the multiply sign. We can write 1 below the x, and then we write the multiplicative inverse of the next number. So that means we will write 1 upon x equals to 2 upon 3 is to the power. Okay, now we can use the law, using law that p upon q is to the power minus m. As I told you, it will become q upon p is to the power m that we have done in the initial part of the experiment. So it will become minus 2 upon 3 is to the power 3 into 1 upon x equals to 2 upon 3 is to the power. Okay. Now this, we can write this minus 2 upon 3 into minus 2 upon 3 into minus 2 upon 3 into 1 upon x equals to, we can write 2 upon 3 into 2 upon 3. Okay. Minus 2 into minus 2 into minus 2 became minus 8. 3 into 3 into 3 became 27 into 1 upon x. So this will be 2 into 2 is 4. 3 into 3 is 9. Okay. So now we will take 8 upon 27 to the other side and it will be dividing that. So 1 upon x will be equal to 4 upon 9 divided by minus 8 upon 7. Okay. So now we will use the rule, the same that we have learned into the rational numbers. So 1 upon x will be equal to 4 upon 9 into, then we will write multiplicative inverse, 27 upon minus 8. 9, 3 is 27, 4 1 is 4, 4 2 is 8. Okay, so we got 1 upon x equals to 3 upon minus 2. So now we will reverse the number. Okay, so when we reverse 1 upon x, it will become x. And now when we reverse 2 or 3 upon minus 2, it will become minus 2 upon 3. So the number, so it should be divided by minus 2 upon 3 is the answer. I hope you would have got it. First, what we have done, we have assumed the number to be x. Then we divided it, make the equation, then we change the sign to multiplication, then we do the multiplicative inverse, then we opened the exponents, then we shifted it, then we divided it. Okay, and answer finally we have arrived, minus 2 upon 3. Now, do the next question, 10th question. Now, in the 10th question, we have find the value of m for which 9 up to power m divided by 3 to power minus 2 is nice to power 4. Okay. So we have to find the value of m. So we will write 9 is to power m divided by 3 is to power minus 2 equal to 9 is to power 4. Okay. So we will write 9 is to power m. Now the division sign is there. So we will just put the multiplication sign and we will write the multiplicative inverse of 3 is to power minus 2. And as we know the multiplicative inverse, we either can reverse the number or we can just change the sign of the exponent. So its multiplicative inverse will become 3 to the power 2, which is equal to 9 to the power. So 3 to the power 2 can be written as 3 into 3 is to the power 9. 3 to the power 2 is 9, is equal to 9 to the power 4. Okay. So now we have both the base same. So 9 is to the power m plus 1 equals to 9 to the power 4. We have used the law h to the power m into h to the power n equals to h to the power m plus n. Since no power is there, so we can assume it to be 1. So now, both bases are same. we have the equal sign between them, so that means their exponents must be same. So we will write m plus 1 equal to 4. We have just equalizes the exponent because their bases are same and they have the equal sign between them. So we just shift m to the other side, so it will become m equal to 4 minus 1. So m became equal to 3. Okay, in this question, what we have done, we have just changed the sign to multiplication and wrote the multiplicative inverse. Then 3 to power 2 became equal to 9, which can be written as 9 to power 1. Then we used the law in h to power m into h to power n. So it became 9 to power m plus 1. So now, since both the bases are equal, there is an equal sign between them. That means their power should also be same. So m plus 1 equal to 4. So we got the value m equal to 3. See, in the 11th question, we have minus 5 upon 7 is to power minus 4 into minus 5 upon 7 is to power 12 equal to 5 minus 5 upon 7 is to power 3 is to power x minus 5 upon 7 is to power minus 1. So we have to find the value of x. Okay. So we have the question minus 5 upon 7 is to power minus 4 into minus 5 upon 7 is to power 12 equals to minus 5 upon 7 is to power 3 is to power x into minus 5 upon 7 is to power minus 3. Here the bases are same, 5 upon 7 and minus 5 upon 7. So we can use the law that h to power m into h to power n equal to h to power m plus n. So it will become minus 5 upon 7 is to power minus 4 plus 12. Okay? Because minus is here, so we can write the minus. Now we will write 3 into x. We will use the law now. A is to power m is to power n equal to h to power m into n. So this 3 and x will be multiplied. Okay? So we will write minus 5 upon 7 3x into minus 5 upon 7 is to power minus 4 plus 12 is 12 minus 4. 12 minus 4, it will become 8. So minus 5 upon 7 is to the power 8. Now, the same law that the first one that we have used will use here also because we have the same base. So it will become minus 5 upon 7, 3x, and we will write minus 1 because this power is minus. Okay, we have used the same law. So that means, now, as we have done in the question number 10 also, both way, on the both side, we have the same base, minus 5 upon 7. We have the equal sign between them. So that means this power 8 and this 3x minus 1. This one and this one will become equal. So that means 8 equal to 3x minus 1. Now this minus 1 will shift to the other side. So it will become 8 plus 1 equal to 3x. And 8 plus 1 is 9, which is equal to 3x. Now we will shift 3 to the other side. So it will become 9 by 3 equal to x. So we got the answer. X equals to 3 is the answer that we have. Okay. So what we have done here, we have just used the laws of exponent. Okay. And then we have arrived at the answer. I think you watch it 2-3 times. When you watch it 2-3 times, you will come to know about what is exactly happening into the question. Okay. Now the question number 12. In question number 12, we have to find x if minus 2 upon 3 is to power minus 13 into 3 upon 2 is to power 8 equal to minus 2 upon 3 is to power minus 2x plus 1. So the question is minus 2 upon 3 is to the power minus 13 into 3 upon minus 2 is to the power 8 will be equal to minus 2 upon 3 is to the power minus 2x plus 1. We have to find the value of x. Okay. So what we can do here to make it easier, we can just convert this. We can write p upon q is to the power m equals to q upon p is to the power m minus m. See, we are now using the opposite way. Since till now we had been converting in the negative exponent into the positive, now what we can do, we can convert the positive exponent to negative exponent so that we can arrive at the same base. Okay, so it will become minus 2 upon 3 is to the power minus 13 into, so it will become minus 2 upon 3 is to the power minus 8. We have done reverse. Okay, so minus 2 upon 3 x to the power minus 2x plus 1. Now, these both bases are same, so we can use the law that x to the power minus m into x to the power minus m equal to x to the power minus m bracket plus n. Okay, so we will use minus 2 upon 3 x to the power minus 13 minus 8 equal to minus 2 upon 3 x to the power minus 2x plus 1. So minus 13 minus 8 will become positive, but sign will be negative. So we got minus 21. So minus 2 upon 3 x to the power minus 21 will be equals to minus 2 upon 3 minus 2x plus 1. Now again, as we have done in the question number 10 and 11, same here. Now the bases are same. Okay. So that means their power would also be same. So that means minus 21 will become equal to minus 2x plus 1. Okay. We can shift minus 2x to the this side, left side, and 21 to the right side. So it will become 2x equal to 1 plus 21, which is equal to 22. Okay. So now we will take 2 to the other side. It will divide it. So x equals to 22 by 2. So 11. So we got the answer. X equal to 11. We got the answer. Okay. So what we have done in this question, we just did the reverse. We just converted the positive exponent into the negative exponent. So we will arrive at the same base, because minus 2 upon 3 is the base here. So when we reverse it, so it will also become minus 2 upon 3. And this also becomes minus 2 upon 3. Then we have used the law. Okay, so we arrived at minus 2 upon 3 is to our minus 21. Then we have equalized the both powers, because the base is same. And then we have got the answer x equals to 11 is the answer. Okay, so now the next question. So 13, we will do the first part. We have 5 is to power 2x minus 1 equal to 1 upon 125x is to power x minus 3. We have to find x. Okay. So we have question 5 is to power 2x minus 1 equal to 1 upon 125 is to power x minus 3. So 125 we can write as a 5 into 5 into 5. That means which is equal to 5 to power 3. So we will write 5 2x minus 1 exponent upon 5 to power 3 is to power x minus 3. Now here in this one, we will use the laws of exponent. Like a is to the power m is to the power n. See, we can put this into brackets so that bond mass will be applied equal to a is to the power m into n. So it will become 5 is to the power 2x minus 1 equal to 1 upon, we have 5, 3 into x is 3x, and minus 3 into 3 is minus. Okay, now we can reverse this. So now 1 upon a is to the power m becomes a is to the power minus m. So that means 5 is to the power 2x minus 1 will be equal to 5 is to the power minus 3x bracket minus 9. We will put this into bracket. Okay. So now the both ways the bases are same. So the power will also be same as we have done earlier in the questions. So 2x minus 1 will be equal to minus 3x and minus 9. Now we will open this bracket. So we have 2x minus 1, which is equal to minus 3x plus 9. Okay, so minus 3x will come to the other side, so it will become 2x plus 3x, and minus 1 will go to the other side, it will become plus 1. So we have 5x equals to 10. Now 5 will go to the other side, so it will divide that. So x equals to 10 upon 5, 5 to the 10, so we got the value x equals to 2. So what we have done in this question is, we have changed the 125 to the power of the 5, then we multiplied these two powers, and then we equalized the powers, and the equation was made, and after solving it, we got the answer x equals to 2. Okay, now the second part. So we have been given the question, if 9 is to power n into 3 is to power 5 into 27 is to power 3 equal to 27, we have to find the value of n. See, all these 3-4 questions are in the same pattern. Okay, so it is 9 is to power n h to 3 is to power 5 into 27 is to power 3 upon 3 into 81 is to power 4 equals to 27. So what will we do here? We will write 9 as a 3 is to power 2 is to power n. then into 3 to power 5. Then 27 can be written as 3 to power 3. 3 into 3 into 3 is to power outside 3. Equal to 3. And 81. 81 can be written as 3, 3 the 9, 3 the 27 and 3 the 81. These 3 is to power 4 we can write. So 3 is to power 4 is to power 4. And then again 27 can be written as 3 is to power 3. Okay. So now, this we can use 2 into n, that means a is to power m outside power n equals to a is to power m into n. So it became 3 is to power 2n into 3 is to power 5. Same here, 3 into 3, 9 into 3 is to power 9 upon 3 into 4 into 4 is 16. Okay, 3 is to power 3. Clear? I hope this is clear to you. We have all the same basis, so we just add them the powers. So 3 is to power 2n plus 5 plus 9 upon 3 is to the power 1 into 3 is to the power 16 equal to 3 is to the power 3. So it will become 3 is to the power 2n plus 14. Okay. Now this upon 3 is to the power 1 plus 16 equal to 3 is to the power 3. Okay. So it will become 3 to the power 2n plus 14 upon 3 to the power 17 equal to 3 to the power 3. Now this 17 will go up. So there we can use a to the power m upon a to the power n equals to a to the power m minus n. So it will become 3 to the power 2n plus 14 minus 17 equal to 3 to the power 3. So this will become 3 to the power 2n and 14 minus 17 is minus 3, which is equal to 3 to the power 3. Okay. Now, as we have done in the earlier questions also, we have the same base. So, their power will also be same. So, we will write 2n minus 3 will be equal to 3. So, 3 will shift to the other side. So, it will become 2n equal to 3 plus 3, which is equal to 6. Now, 2 will go to the other side. So, that means n will become 6 divided by 2, 3. That means n equal to 3, so we have got the answer n. Okay, so let's repeat. So what we have done in this question, we just converted all the big numbers into the powers of the 3, like 9 is 3 to power 2, 27 is 3 to power 3, 81 is 3 to power 4. Then we multiplied the both outside and inside powers. Okay, we got the answer 3 to the power 2 and into 3 to the power 5 into 3 to the power 9 upon 3 into 3 to the power 16. Then upper side, we just added all the powers because all the bases are same. And the lower side also we added all the power because both are same. And then, since both up and down, means numerator and denominator, both have the same base, so we just subtracted the powers. Okay, so we had arrived at the equation because the bases are same. 2n minus 3 equal to 3. So by solving it, we got the value of n is a. So students, here the exercise 2 finishes. I hope you would have understood the whole exercises in different videos. Okay. If you have any doubt, then you can write to me. So definitely we can share more experience, more knowledge. You can clear your more queries in the videos. Okay. So, dear students, in the next video, we will take the objective type questions. These are the questions other than exercise now we will take, which normally the students don't do, but if you practice them, okay, so there are more chances of getting them into the examination, okay. So, and under that, we will do the mental maths and multiple choice questions we will cover into the next video. Thank you so much for your watching. Write your comments about the video and any query, doubt about the topic into the comment box. I hope you must be getting knowledge from these videos and I hope you must be practicing also. Okay. If you have any doubt, then you can write to me on WhatsApp or email also. And if you want to do the live online classes through Zoom app, then you can also write to me on the WhatsApp or email. We will be happy to share the details with you. And I hope you must be getting knowledge from these videos. Kindly share with your friends. Subscribe to it. Ask your friends to subscribe. And keep practicing each and every question 4 to 5 times. You will become best into the math. Thank you so much.